Welcome to the stage, Mark Hurley from Schneider Electric. Now, a lot of you will obviously be familiar with Schneider. The Interconnect Lounge is just behind us on the main stage here, leading the way in many respects in terms of the work being done on sustainability, not just for this, our data centre industry, but across all the sectors you work in. Do you want to briefly introduce yourself, Mark, in terms of your role and the work that you're doing for Schneider right now?
Sure. My name is Mark Hurley. I'm a data center solution architect with Schneider. I've been with Schneider for 9 years, and I focus on, I focus on helping customers with their data center strategy, data center solutions. I came from the end user side of things. I came from a large financial institution and managed their data center portfolio and data center design standards and also energy and sustainability for their global real estate portfolio.
And sustainability is certainly in sharp focus right now. In the debate rooms yesterday, I think no matter which debate people were in, whether they were talking about edge or cooling or site selection, sustainability was really at the forefront. How have your customer demands evolved over the past couple of years, and how is what they're requiring from yourselves as a solution provider changing?
Yeah, well, that's a loaded question. So let me just kind of put things into context and the way I think about things. You know, the data center industry has focused for the last 15 years on increasing resiliency and increasing efficiency, and we've done a great job at that. But now the focus, the added thing we're focused on is sustainability and what's driving that. So when we look at efficiency is about minimizing our consumption and maximizing our output. And the data center industry has done a great job on that. And because of the work that they've done, you know, focusing on PUE with all its flaws, you know, we've driven down the energy consumption relative to the work output and limited the energy growth in this sector. I just heard a new stat from Dean Nelson. You know, it used to be they estimated the data centers consume 1 to 2% of the world's energy. According to Dean's comments, it consumes about 2.4%. So you can see it's increasing. We've limited it. If we hadn't done what we've done with efficiency, we would have been 2 to 3 times that and spiraling out of control. So great job to the data center industry. So when we look at sustainability is about balancing our consumption with the world's economic or ecological resources. And that's what we need to strive, because it's not sustainable to keep increasing energy consumption and consuming all of our world's resources at a greater pace than we can replenish them. So let me give you a little perspective. You interviewed one of my colleagues in New York, and he talked about this thing that I found interesting. It's called Earth Overshoot Day, right? And back in 1971, the world was consuming energies or resources at a greater rate than the world could sustain. And we ran out of the resources by December 25th. So that means there's a few days where we're drawing down more than we can produce, right? The Earth can sustain. Today in 2022, that date is July 28th. So that means after July 28th, we are consuming resources at a greater rate. And so let me give you a real world example. California should be aware of this. Look at the water resource challenge we have, right? Look at Lake Mead. We have been consuming more water than we can replenish in Lake Mead, and it's resulting in a crisis. And that's why we need to focus on sustainability. We need to move that in that direction. So what are our customers seeing? You know, what are our customers thinking about? Why are they moving towards sustainability? And the bottom line is it makes good business sense, right? So, you know, we have a climate crisis that we're facing. You know, we're seeing increased floods, increased fires, increased tornadoes, record heat waves. All of these things are impacting society, and data centers can play a role in helping to minimize that or reverse that trend. And it's not just the data center world that's focused on sustainability, but you know, we're here talking about what can data centers do. So from a business perspective, there's been some surveys done, and 83% of CEOs say that focusing on sustainability can increase shareholder value over the next 5 years. That makes good business sense. From a people perspective, you know, we have people that want to work for companies that are focused on sustainability. So you think about retention of employees and attracting employees, that makes good business sense, because we're in a competition right now for the workforce. And then, you know, when we look at from a risk perspective, sustainability solutions can help reduce risk, and the data center industry has always been focused on risk. So we want to look at it from a risk perspective. So it just makes good business sense for companies to focus on sustainability.
Well, let's dive into the risk that you were talking about a little bit. You mentioned California and some of the challenges with the climate here and the pressure generally on the grid. Is the industry now ready to explore more on-site renewables, and what are the alternatives there in terms of energy sourcing that we should be looking at and thinking about?
Yeah, I think it's no surprise that the grid is being stressed. We haven't made major investments in our infrastructure, our transportation, our grid infrastructure in over 40 years. And what we're seeing with increased temperatures, we're seeing increased power demand. I have a little smart thermostat in my home. The other day, it was approaching 100 degrees in Charlotte, North Carolina, and I wanted to turn it down. It gives me a little alarm saying, hey, it's we're having an energy strain on the grid. Do you really want to increase the temperature? So, you know, we're seeing increased brownouts, we're seeing increased blackouts, and that presents operational risk. And data centers have always protected themselves against operational risk. So we got diesel generators that back up our data centers so we can go off the grid. But diesel generators are polluting the environment, right? They generate pollutants that increase greenhouse gases. And from a sustainability perspective, we want to start mitigating greenhouse gases. So I think we need to move towards more renewable energies. And those renewable energies can be on-site and supporting the data center, local, on-site, becoming, instead of a consumer of energy, be a prosumer of energy. I have a friend recently, he just told me he's putting in solar panels on his house that is going to generate 130% of the demand that he needs to support his house. So not only is he powering his house for free with the solar installation, but he's also pushing power back onto the grid, making it available for others. So I think we need a combination of on-site renewable energy, and we need a combination of grid-scale renewable energy. And, you know, what's changing in the industry and making it possible for us to do this is the cost of solar panels is coming down. The cost of natural gas is coming down. The invention or coming out with lithium ion batteries has made it possible for us to store that energy and then discharge it when needed later on. And I think in the battery industry, there's a lot of innovation going on in the battery industry. Lithium ion batteries isn't the end all. There are other battery technologies. I think we have a company over here called Zinc that is developing a new battery technology. So I think we're going to see more in battery energy storage, because one of the challenges from a data center operator's perspective is renewable energy sources like solar and like wind, they're temporary, right? And we need guaranteed runtime. So to the extent that we can store energy that we produce, this excess energy that we produce from these renewable energy sources, then we'll have the ability to protect us from some runtime. Maybe we reduce and still have some generators, but it's a combination of generators and other renewable energy resources.
Thank you. Well, let me pick up a couple of threads of what you were saying. We'll come back to the data center as a prosumer, because that's been a big theme of this week. Mm-hmm. But before we do, you spoke about the thermostat in your house giving you a warning the need for a more proactive approach in terms of operating sustainably. And we talk here is called sustainability through software. So can we look at some of the software solutions? I guess to just taking a more proactive approach and managing energy consumption more effectively.
Yeah, well, we're becoming a digitized world, and software is going to be the key enabler to achieving our sustainability goals. And I think in the future, what we're going to see is more interaction between the facility infrastructure and the IT kit and the facility infrastructure and the grid. And so when we start thinking about putting distributed renewable energy sources on site, we're creating a microgrid. We already have a microgrid on a data center site because we have utility coming in and we have generators, so we can go off grid and support. But what we're talking about is expanding beyond the generators and adding other distributed energy resources. Could be fuel cells, solar, wind, et cetera, battery energy storage. And what we need is software that can make intelligent decisions of when to engage and utilize those distributed energy resources. And the decisions may be based on risk. So for example, we see a thunderstorm coming through or we have high temperatures and the grid is getting stressed and unstable, and we may want to intentionally move over to these distributed energy resources. It could be based on a cost decision, a cost savings decision. We want to engage these, if we have good solar, we have a full battery energy storage system, and we're peaking in our utility consumption, the rates that during the day in a hot summer month, we may want to shift over for a few hours and reduce our kW demand. So it's kind of like load shedding. BMS systems have been set up to do some type of load shedding. So we have software that is not only looking at what's going on in the site, but is looking at our utility rate schedule. It may be looking at weather. It's pulling data from the cloud, and it's making intelligent decisions based on what you want to achieve. And it's user defined. The user can say, here's when when I want to go to save money, or when I want to go on these resources to reduce my operational risk.
And software enables that innovation in approach and the shift from utility to DER to some degree. What does that future grid relationship look like? We talked about data centers as prosumers. We talked about load shedding. You touched upon demand response. What's the scale of that opportunity? And how are you expecting that utility relationship to evolve?
It differs from utility to utility. Some utilities will allow you to push energy back onto their grid. Others do not. It's probably for economic reasons why they want to do that or not. But I think it's going to be something that is imperative. The utility companies don't want to invest more capital in building more power plants, right? That takes. So I know my utility company in my area, they've shipped me the free smart thermostat for my house. They shipped me free LED bulbs to my house. Why are they doing that? Is because it limits the demand on their existing plants and helps them prevent having to spend more capital. So I think we really need some grid scale renewable energy. And I think corporations are driving that and helping facilitate that, because right now, to become carbon neutral, if you have a carbon neutral plan, a lot of that involves purchasing renewable energy credits or RECs, right? And that's a good thing, because that expense is going to help fund those renewable energies, those grid scale renewable energy. And it's going to be a journey, and it's going to be a long journey. It's not going to happen overnight. So we have a long ways to go from that perspective.
You talked about the offsets and the credits, and you mentioned PUE earlier in the conversation. Do these evolving relationships and innovations also change the metrics that we need to look at when we're talking about sustainable operations?
Well, yeah. I mean, that's the challenge right now. I think you heard the previous speaker, Dean Nelson, talk about getting these labels on products that will tell you what the carbon footprint is of these products. we need standards in the industry, and the iMasons is working on those standards. We've joined that committee, you know, and they said it's open to everybody because we want to help influence. But Schneider Electric has been focused on sustainability for over 15 years, and we are recognized in the industry. We get awards all the time as being one of the most sustainable companies. And we've been working and have recently released a new white paper that's focused on how do you create a framework for a strategy around achieving sustainability and measuring, you know, what are the measurements, the benchmarks. And, you know, there's five different areas that we think you need to focus on. One is energy, and we've been focusing on that. And PUE is one of those metrics, as good or as bad, you know, with all of its caveats. But then there's greenhouse gas metrics. And we have five energy metrics, nine greenhouse gas metrics, four water metrics, four waste metrics, and one land and biodiversity metric. And these metrics were not something that Schneider created. We went out there and looked at all these governmental bodies and agencies that have developed metrics, and we found ones that we thought applied to the data center industry and could be easily implemented. And that's the key. And when we say easy, it's not going to be easy. I still think that there's a lot of challenge. It's hard enough with PUE, just gathering that. When you think about PUE, it's a very simple metric. And it works well if all you have is a data center. It doesn't work well if you have a data center in a mixed-use facility. Now you got to start putting a lot more instrumentation and metering to be able to segregate out what component of that multi-use facility is associated with the data center. Then it becomes a hard metric to implement. So there are lots of metrics that we need to focus on and give us perspective on what our total sustainability profile looks like.
Yeah, great, thank you. For those of you watching the live stream, that white paper that Mark was describing with those series of metrics, it's available on datacenterdynamics.com. I'm doing my usual poor job of timekeeping, I think. So we'll wrap up with a little bit of future gazing if we can, Mark. We talked about the use of software to help us get there faster. We talked about the data centers becoming prosumers. How do you see this moving 5-10 years down the line? What's the data center of the future going to look like?
So I think we're at the beginning of our journey, and I think everybody is focused. I mean, you look at this conference, there's a lot of effort focused on sustainability. It's the new PUE or edge discussion, right? And that now it's going to be sustainability for the next 5 years or longer. So, simply put, I think it involves three components. You need to strategize, you need to digitize, and then you need to decarbonize, right? And you gotta measure and set a benchmark of what your carbon footprint is. So that's that digitizing your world and collecting data. And then you gotta put in plans in place to start decarbonizing. How are we going to achieve net zero or carbon, you know, neutral, carbon negative, water positive, all these things that are going to help us be a more sustainable world.
Thank you very much. Strategize, digitize, decarbonize, like the tri-party trend. And thanks for being with us, Mark.
Thank you.
For those of you who are interested in looking at the software in more detail, the Schneider Electric Lounge is just behind us here. And demos are available from the lounge. Thanks, Mark.